Hello guys, and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, our Let's Play series. In this episode I am going to tame this little sulfur geyser as it keeps erupting and therefore heating up the environment. So basically the plan is to seal this one into a little room, let the hot sulfur just spill over here into this room and basically fill this room with a little amount of water. Yeah, we can use water, that's a good idea. And we will have a cooling on top just for a steam turbine to constantly keep running. Let's keep this open for a second. Also, I've noticed we are quite low on ceramics here. Yeah, actually I think we don't need to build this from ceramics entirely. Maybe the parts that will be or will have connections to hot items, such as the steam turbine on top here. So much at the bottom, I think, something like that. And for the rest we can just use igneous. So that's gonna be the part of the chamber as well. Let's keep some entries open for the moment. There. Let's place a steam turbine on top. You can just place that, let's say here. Actually, in that case, we won't need to block so much room over here. Enough room to put a transformer just about here. Transformer for both the automation sweeping and also the echo tuner. This one will require some heavy watt wires. This time. Will not be necessary anyway. Then we will need some water inside here and some inside here as well. What's actually wrong with the ceramics production? Let's check that. Oh, we do have enough clay and also coal and 50 tons. Why is there nothing? Oh no, it finally started. Maybe let's check the shipping here as well. So this is just transporting coal, I think. Oh, that's so hard to see already. So we have, yeah, coal from here. critter eggs. Okay. Makes sense to also bring them close to the machineries. Then we have a second coal transportation. Why we don't also transport some clay? There's no path for clay, I think. Oh, that's very complicated already. So I think we will need another conveyor loader and just put that clay. So that way we should receive all the clay that is being stored in here. Okay, we do have some iron left. Where's that going? So we will need to connect it to here. That's a shorter path. And we will also need a few bridges there. This actually, oh, there we can get some ceramics from, so we can just seal up from one side. What hasn't been analyzed yet as well. And we will also have to set this to consumable ore. And there we have clay. No, we don't. We have organics. Probably no. Where's that in? Filtration. Cultivable soil. Oh, great. It seems the auto sweeper has nothing in range. No clay here. So, pretty much in vain then. And where's all the clay? I mean, we could just find the clay on the map and sweep that up, so it will eventually be transported by the conveyor loader. But where is it actually? Is there... I think it's under organic. We can't see any clay here. Oh, there we have some. That's polluted dirt. No, it's under cultivable soil, exactly. Phosphorite dirt. A lot of dirt on this map. What is blue? That's fertilizer. Where's our clay? I mean, according to what it says here, we should have roughly 20 tons on this map available. 90 tons. Is there a way to search that? Other than just looking on the map, using some filters, fertilizer. Suit. That's dirt. Okay, here we have phosphorite. Looking for something more greenish. There we have it. Oh, that's all at the bottom of the map. Oh, we only want to pick up the clay. before we seal this, we will actually clean this up. Where were we? Yeah, exactly here. Okay, there's some water falling down here. What is it actually? That's salt water. That should stop from entering. Duplicants can't actually reach this place anyway. No, they can't. That's probably explaining why we have so much clay. Oh no, I really wanna just pick up the clay here. So yeah, that should give us access to clay. There's a few tons of it down here. Yeah, another ton here. 500 kilograms there. 1400. That explains why we came so low on ceramics. Let's check Curdona for a moment. There's still a lot of workarounds here. Seems duplicants are still transporting some materials in here. But I think this is set up to all, isn't it? No, not exactly all. Because there's so much stuff over here, for instance, eggshells. The duplicants don't seem to be in a hurry here. Okay, seems the clay is being used now. Yeah, exactly. There the clay goes. Over to the left, and just next to the kilns. But what materials are missing now? Is it coal or what? Yeah, exactly. No, we don't have coal. Great. Great. Can we just also allow coal here? Or is that... That's rust and salt. That's filtration. Okay. We can just add consumable ore, coal as well. Yeah. I just saw our first piece of coal being transported as well. I don't like that we still have so many coal generators here. I mean, it's being automated from there. And we have only 4 with an automatic access. I wanna reduce the amount of travel time for the duplicants, so I'm gonna remove a few. But it seems they are still needed from time to time, so we might have to take care of this energy grid eventually. What is actually connected to this energy grid? Let's pause for a second. That's this cooling loop. Part of our base is going down here. A lot of transit tubes as well. That goes up here even more of our base. Yeah, it seems like most of the base is being supplied with power by this power grid. So that would be ideal to have some nuclear power, but because we don't have any bees, probably not gonna have nuclear power anytime soon. Also need to remove the gases from here, so we need basically we'll need 2 liquid locks, but we can build them from igneous easily. That's gonna be the first, and we have a second one just so. Then we gonna need 2 gas pumps. We are also receiving a lot of sulfur here. Can we... we should actually place the auto sweeper one tile to the right. If that is possible, that way we would cover the entire room. Would be able to transport sulfur as well. Clay production operational now. has a little poke shell jumping around from the eggs. But it seems we do have our stables full. Why are you glum, buddy? Is that not ideal temperature or what? Comfort up to 70, at least it is close. 69, 70, somewhere here. Okay, it's a bit hot now. It's probably because of the salt geyser, is that correct? Yes. Has been demolished. Let's check if we can put that here. Of course we can't. Can we place it this way? No, it will still not reach. Okay, then we're just gonna go this way. Actually liquid locks in place already now. Interesting. Just from the salt geyser probably. Not so much our problem at the moment. So yeah, this pump is already overflowing the gases. Thing, yeah, I don't want salt water in the room. Oh no, I don't need to yet. Because I will seal the room here. Okay, now we can start this pump. And we will need some automation for the aqua tuner. Where is it? Ah, oh, it's under plumbing. Yep. I wonder if we could just place it here. Connect that to the grid. Also some automation for the auto sweeper. For that I'm just gonna use a cycle sensor. So we already got good amount of water in there, just a bit more I think. Oh wait, do we have steam now? So we have a vacuum in this room already, that is good. Remove all the piping and the vent. And probably also the power grid. Okay, this room is already down to milligrams. Now we have grams up here. Yeah, that is because there's no real connection down there. Only when the liquid solidifies on this volcano, this part of the carbon will actually down here. And also a bit of a problem is that we have so much liquid sulfur in there already. It seems like The eruption is huge, is it? 6 kilograms per second. How much does, for instance... No, that's at 10 kilograms. Can't be that much, actually. Okay, we do have enough water as well now. Okay, we can set the sensor. Oh, and also, before I forget that, we will need some conveyor rails. We don't have a conveyor loader already. No, there's no space in this room because of this stupid gas pump. Solve that. Don't want to place it here because it will be underwater. Good places there. This is already a border of the room. Okay, so I guess we will have to. Yeah, we will have to feed the cooling loop first so we can get rid of. Yeah, that already happened. Now the pump cannot work anymore. Materials available, but still, because of this little entry over there, we can't place the liquid reservoir. Finally sent the rocket back. More crew boarded, not yet, but no. No. Who's still missing? 2 or 3 boarded. See that you Oh. That's interesting. Ada must have been there for quite some time, I think. That would also explain why we made so slow progress on constructing and digging. There's Ada. Yeah, exactly. That was her job. I wonder how long she is being trapped in there. Can you not just... yeah. Now you can leave, I think. Oh, you can't actually. Come on, let me click the button. Acknowledge warnings begins sequence. Okay, in the meantime we have this little finished. Also we can seal the Equituna in. So that is before the Equituna, put that to 14, that way we can cool down to 0 degrees. Okay, we can start getting some super coolant here. Great job, buddies. Oh, actually, we can't just deconstruct here because then we would spill more water inside here and have more steam inside there. It's not gonna happen. Oh, let's check the other. We do have another 20 tons, 5 tons of gold and 2 tons of fullerene to be sent back to our asteroid. That's good. Oh, come on, it's work time. reservoir is missing. Because of that, the coolant cannot be pumped into the circuit, into the loop. Yeah, exactly. That is what I didn't want to happen. There's also water. How did water get there? Really, sometimes this game can be very annoying. So we have not, no, we don't have, fortunately we don't have any water in the loop so far. We should take care of that very soon. Come on, please clean this up before. Just really, these duplicants. Finally, thanks Max. But there's still a little amount of water on top here. Because of that, yeah, exactly. We do have water in the loop now. Good job. Donkeys. So what we can do is just remove the loop from working again, but there's even more water on top here. Guys, I can see that. You're cheating. How did water get there? It's probably from the steam something, I don't know. Then we have solid types, this was to be expected. So great. Now we can't get the water outside the loop except for with a filter. Really, I hate that so much. Liquid filter. So we're gonna filter out the. Didn't I just. Power. So the little amounts of liquid sulfur that are spilling over here should immediately solidify and therefore never convert into a solid tile. That's at least the plan. Okay, we're gonna filter super coolant here because super coolant will be fed back to the circle and everything else not. Of the time. Oh, there's more power needed. Where's sulfur? Is that in here? No. Liquefiable miscellaneous. There it is. Really, that was a mess, but it seems like it is almost finished. Did we filter all the water? It seems like. I leave that running for a little longer just for security reasons. I don't trust this. Anyways, guys, I think this is it for this episode. Hope to see you next time again. Goodbye.